If you're the kind of person that enjoys learning by watching tutorials online, if you feel like you do not need to sit in a classroom or in a live stream event, then I'm here to tell you that you can learn this all for free. Do not pay for any of the classes online because you don't need to. There's so many free resources online. So what I wanted to do today is share with you the approach that I took. First, what I recommend that you do is go on FAA's website that talks about the requirements to becoming a drone pilot. The website covers things such as requirements, eligibility, and other really important information. So study that information very carefully. Next, I recommend that you watch Tony Northrup's video on the study guide for becoming a drone pilot. His video is very thorough and covers all the different aspects that you're going to be tested on. So I watched the video. It's about 2 hours. If I remember right, it's either an hour and a half or 2 hours long. And the great thing is you can always go back and rewatch the video. So then I tapped into other test takers' feedback. And most of them were saying that the test as of late was very much focused on understanding how to read sectional charts, being able to read TAFs and METARs, understanding longitude and latitude, and being able to understand weather conditions. And those were the four areas that I felt like I needed to dive in a lot deeper. In order for me to be able to do that, I tapped into these resources here. The information I'm covering in this video, I'm also going to put it in the description part. I'm going to list all the information so that you have the links to the videos and sources that I tapped into. So now that you have a very good understanding of the material that you're going to be tested on, I went back to FAA's website and downloaded the official study guide. Now, you might ask yourself, why did you wait until this point to download the information and go through it? Because had I done it initially, before even watching Tony Northrup's video, I would have not understood much about it at all. But now that I have had the crash course, I dove in deeper into certain aspects that I knew I was going to get quizzed on, I utilized the official study guide to essentially just add on my knowledge. It's as if I put a glaze over it, what I already knew. After I studied the information from the FAA, I went to take a practice test. And for that, I referred to PSI's practice test, which is also recommended by the FAA. What you want to make sure is that you score well over 70%. For the real test, you're going to pass with a 70 or above. But you want to be able to walk into the test really confident. And so if you're just around 70%, even 75%, I would go back to the test results and see what areas you can improve on and, you know, improve on those areas. Now, let's just assume you're taking the test. It's test day. My recommendation to you is, and this is easier said than done, but don't panic. Take deep breaths and know that you have quite some time to figure out each one of these questions. If you really think about it, there's 60 questions. You have 2 hours to complete the entire test. That gives you 2 minutes per question. Remember, when you get to sectional chart questions, a lot of the answers are going to be in the legend, in the chart. You'll have that in front of you. So go back to the legend and see if you can't find the information there. If you're confused about a question, go back to that question, reread it. You want to make sure that you really understand what the question is asking you. I wish you the very best of success in taking the course if you choose to do so. Please let me know if this video was educational for you. I'd love to hear from you. Also, subscribe and ring the bell. I really appreciate it. Thank you.